I want to go over talking about just the axis designations on a Swiss machine. When it gets into multipath controls and things like that, a lot of people can be intimidated by the number of axes that are kind of in what we call a crowded tool zone. That's really what makes a Swiss machine very unique, is the tight tool zone. It makes it very fast, but it can also be a little intimidating with that many axes. So I just wanted to kind of go over and explain a typical Swiss machine, two-path control. This is in a posed gang-style Swiss machine. Pardon the rudimentary drawing here, but I think everybody would get the gist of this. This would be your front gang slide on an opposed style machine. This is called a pose because obviously we have two gang slides here and they oppose each other. So front gang slide, rear gang slide, and this would be NC2, the back working block. So you have your main spindle, sub spindle, back working block, and then you have your gang slides here, okay? Now, some machines are not opposed gang style, they may be a vertical gang style. And that would basically take this coordinate system and turn it like this and eliminate this gang slide completely. We can go into that in a different video. So for opposed gang style Swiss, typically this is the way it's gonna be laid out. Your main spindle is always gonna be NC1 and your sub spindle is always gonna be NC2. The main spindle side is gonna have the standard Cartesian coordinate X, Y, and Z1. So you have X1, which is gonna be your diameters, your tooling is gonna face the spindles. So this would be X1. Y1 is gonna be vertical, okay? And Z1 is gonna be your main spindle movement. So that's gonna be your sliding headstock moving back and forth. On NC2, this would be your subspindle side. Very similar, just going the opposite direction. Z2, subspindle is gonna be moving towards the tools. So your tools would actually be in here, facing the subspindle out. So Z2 would feed into the tools. X2 is the subspindle moving horizontally from tool to tool. And Y2 is the block itself moving up and down. Some manufacturers may have the Y2 on the subspindle as well. So the subspindle would move and this would stay stationary. For more rigidity, Tsugami tends to put the Y2 on its own block, on the back working block, and separates it from the subspindle to keep some more strength there in that subspindle. So you have X1, Y1, Z1. That's gonna be your main spindle side. And then your back side is gonna be X2, Y2, and Z2. That's gonna be your subspindle side. So two sets of Cartesian coordinates on one set on each path. That's how the axis designation works on a typical two-path Swiss machine.